Hello everyone. So let's get started with the next session on underground cables. So the learning objectives of this particular session are, so in this session you will be able to understand the importance and types of grading of cables. You will get to know why cables has to be graded and what are the advantages of grading the cables, underground cables. And we will also derive expressions for capacitance of single core cable, charging current, and dielectric loss. So let's get started with grading of cables. So this is the expression that we had derived in the last class, potential gradient, maximum, G maximum, and G minimum. So how would it affect the value of GM? How would it affect the stress on the cable? All that we had discussed in the last session. So let's get started. What exactly is grading of cables and why is it so important? So this expression says that dielectric stress is not uniform for a given size of cable size and voltage. So when you say that the dielectric stress is not uniform for a given particular voltage and cable size, insulation will not be proper. So it will be uneven. It is not properly utilized. In simple words, you can also say that it is uneven. So when you say that the insulation is not even, if it is uneven, there will definitely be a problem of insulation failure. Okay. As a result, grading of cable is a process of balancing the stress. So earlier in the insulation, if the grading is not done properly, insulation will not be properly utilized. So it leads to insulation failure. That is because of the stress is not uniform throughout the cable size. It will be more on one particular side and it will be less on one particular side. So that will not give rise to a better insulation of cable. As a result, grading is a process of balancing the stress. It makes the stress uniform in the dielectric cable. So when it makes the stress uniform in the cable, it reduces the difference between maximum and minimum, that is G maximum and G minimum. So it has to be, the difference between G max and G min has to be as less as possible. So if it is more, that ensures that the dielectric stress is not uniform, which later leads to insulation failure. So grading is the process of balancing the stress in order to reduce the difference between the G max and G minimum. So this enables the cable to be operated at higher voltage. So when you say that the grading is uniform, so it ensures that there is a proper balance, so you can operate the cable at higher voltages. So when you operate a cable at higher voltages, insulation will also be better. We'll get to know that the insulation is better, that its dial stress is uniform. As a result, that these cables can be operated at higher voltages. So this is the advantage of grading. So there are two methods that are available in order to grade the cables. So that one method is called as capacitance grading and the other one is intersheath grading. So let's see what is capacitance grading or dielectric grading. So this is a diagram wherein you have radius R, R1, R2 and R3. So it's been graded. Okay. So what is this R1, radius R1, radius R2 and radius R3? So the dielectric is placed by layers. Okay, similar dielectric is replaced by layers of dielectric having different values of relative permittivity. As a result, you are getting R, R1, R2 and R3. So similar dielectric will be replaced by layers of dielectric having a different value of relative permittivity. Why is this done? In order to obtain or in order to get a uniform stress. Okay. And in order to obtain uniform stress, we need to use infinite number of dielectric. Infinite number of dielectrics has to be used in order to ensure that there is uniform stress. So electrical stress can be allocated uniformly using two or more dielectrics having suitable permittivity. So what is the expression for dielectric stress as derived in the last session? So it's GA is nothing but Q charge divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon RA. So this is whatever the value of constant is, Q divided by 2 pi epsilon is constant divided by epsilon R and A. So when you consider, so in order to ensure capacitance grading, which is also called as dielectric grading, in order to complete capacitance grading. So you need to consider three dielectrics for a particular cable, wherein each dielectric has a relative permittivity of epsilon 1, epsilon 2, and epsilon 3, such that epsilon 1 is less than epsilon 2 and it is less than epsilon 3. That is as shown in the figure. So let us consider R1, R2, and R3 as the outer radius of the dielectric materials. The radius R1, R2, and R3 is considered as outer radii of the dielectric materials. So what is the potential difference across the inner layer? We will start with this using the previous session equation. The potential difference across the inner layer is V1. So you have layer R1, R1, R2, and R2, R3. So it is V1 is between R and R1 into the potential gradient into the distance that was considered, that is dA. So initially V1 is between R1 and R small r and R1. So GA value is Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 1 A into dA. On simplification, what do you get? You are removing the constant to the other side. Once you remove the constant to the other side, it's Q 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 1 ln R1 by R. Okay, so this gets later simplified as Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 1 and R. So on further simplification, the expression get reduced to R ln R1 by R, which is equal to G maximum R ln capital R1 divided by R. Okay, further simplificating this will be the expression. So this is the expression between the radii R small r and R1. So next we will move on to the potential difference V2 between radii R1 and R2. So this is nothing but in similar grounds you can write it as V2 is equal to G max to R1 ln R2 by R1. So similarly between R2 and R3 is again V3 G max 3 R2 ln R3 by R2. So the net potential difference between the core and the earth sheet is, so you want to know the value of V1 between small r and R capital R1, V2 between R1 and R2, and V3 between R2 and R3. The net potential difference between the core and the earth sheet is V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So later the value of V is G max 1 R ln R1 by R, G max 2 R1 ln R2 by R1, G max 3 R2 ln R3 by R2. So on adding the values of individual potential differences. So what is the capacitance of the cable here? So capacitance of the cable over here is C is equal to, you know the general expression, it is Q divided by V. Q divided by V value, whatever that is obtained in the previous expression is replaced over here. So later C gets reduced to this expression given by 6.12. This is how the value of C get reduced to 2 pi epsilon naught divided by 1 by epsilon 1 ln R1 by R small r plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 ln R2 by R1 plus 1 by epsilon 3 ln R3 by R2. The maximum stress in different layers is given by, so you can, different layers is G max 1 because there are two layers, whatever that you have considered, that is the reason you've got V1, V2 and V3. So G max 1 is nothing but Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 1 R, G max 2 Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 2 R1, and G max 3 is nothing but Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 3 R2. So if you maintain the maximum stress as same in each layer, if it is maintained same across the each layer, so you can later simplify it as G max 1 is equal to G max 2 is equal to G max 3 is equal to G max. On further simplification, you will also be equating epsilon 1 R is equal to epsilon 2 capital R1, epsilon 3 capital R2. So R value is less than R1, small r value is less than R1, capital R1, which is less than capital R2. From the diagram, you can conclude that. But the epsilon value is 1 is greater than epsilon 2 and epsilon 3. So the ratio of different dielectric constants, okay, can be later simplified as this. So V is equal to G max into the values. So what does this Gmax represent? Gmax represent the peak values of electrical stress. Okay, so the main drawback of this particular capacitance grading method is finding the dielectric materials in order to grade, okay, would is totally difficult. Okay, you need, because you need to identify the values in such a way that you need to get graded properly. So in order to ensure that finding the dielectric materials itself is a major task, and hence intersheath grading is widely used because of the drawback of capacitance grading or dielectric grading. What is this intersheath grading? We'll move on to the next one. So intersheath grading over here is, as the name itself is telling, you are using different metallic sheets are used over here. Okay, different metallic sheets are used. So you can consider the value of R1 to be the intersheath, radius of the intersheath. R2 is the radius of the outer sheet. What is the value V1 here? V1 value is the voltage between small r and R1. That is between the core and the intersheath. That is nothing but small r and R1. V2 between voltage between the intersheath and outer sheath. That is between V2 is between capital R1 and capital R2. So let's get started in finding the expression G. So Gmax 1 is nothing but V1 divided by, because V1 is because of small r and capital R1. So it's R ln R1 by R. So the maximum potential gradient between R1 and R2. So Gmax 2 is nothing but, it's because of the potential that is there between radii R1 and R2. So Gmax 2 is nothing but V2 divided by R1 ln R2 by R1. The two potential gradients are equal. If the two potential gradients are equal, Gmax 1 is equal to Gmax 2 is equal to Gmax. So it is, which is later, you can simplify it later. When you equate the values of potential gradients, it's nothing but V1 divided by R ln R1 by R, which is equal to V2 divided by R1 ln R2 by R1. So if you consider that all the potential differences are in phase, then we see that the number of capacitors are in series. This will ensure, if you say that the potential differences over here are in phase, the number of capacitors will also be in series. So therefore, you can equate V is equal to V1 plus V2. So what is this V is equal to? When you equate V, value of V is equal to V1 plus V2, you will get the value of Gmax, value of V as, after equating it to V1 plus V2, Gmax into R ln R1 by R plus R1 ln R2 by R1. So let's see what is this, what are the limitations of grading. The main disadvantage of capacitance grading is that range of permittivity of insulating material available for insulation is very less. It's very limited. So that is, you cannot grade it properly because of this disadvantage. Also, permittivity of layers is uneven. You cannot take the same layers that are having the same permittivity. Even that is uneven. If that is uneven, dielectric stress will also be uneven, causing insulation breakdown, because there will be difference in the stress distribution. But our main intention of grading is to balance. But you don't get the materials in order to balance, because they themselves will have different values. As a result, this is one of the major limitations of capacitance grading. So what is the major disadvantage of intersheath grading? So the layers that are used for intersheath, the materials are very thin. Since they are very thin, they are brittle. They can easily break. That is one of the major drawbacks. The sheets that are used are very thin, so they are liable to damage. As a result, that is a major, and that would be that, because of that, again, insulation would break without ensuring proper balance. This is a major disadvantage of intersheath grading. And also, the current carrying capacity is very low in intersheath grading, because the layers are very thin. Since the layers are thin, its current carrying capacity is also less. So this is one of the major limitations of grading. So let's see what is capacitance of a single core cable. Let us derive an expression for capacitance of single core cable. So what is this portfolio? In order to find out the potential difference, capacitance of single core cable, we should first start with finding the potential difference of a single core cable. So we have used this expression. So V is potential. You can get the potential from the potential gradient, as discussed in the previous session. It's integral R1 to R2 G dA. You are substituting the value of G and later simplifying it, you will get a value of V as Q divided by 2 pi epsilon ln R2 by R1. What is the capacitance can later be found as C is equal to Q divided by V. This is a general expression. So you are substituting the value. So and later QQ get cancelled. And the final expression for capacitance, you will get it as 2 pi epsilon divided by ln R2 by R1 farads per meter. So the capacitance of the cable is much higher than that of overhead conductors due to high permittivity of insulating materials and smaller distance between the core and the earth sheet. This is the inference that we can draw. Yet in this case, the capacitance will be greater than the overhead conductors. Why? Because of the higher value of permittivity of the insulating materials and also the distance between the core and the earth sheet is very, very less. So on substituting the value of epsilon and epsilon naught, the expression gets further reduced to. This will be the expression. This will be the 6.20 will be the expression that is shown over here. Let's move on to the next one, that is charging current. High value of capacitance gives a high value of capacitive reactance. Okay. XC, you know the value of XC. XL is 2 pi FL. XC is 1 divided by 2 pi FC. XC is 1 divided by omega C. High value of capacitance will give you a high value of capacitive reactance. What is the value of charging current over here? IC is nothing but V divided by XC. Okay. So you are substituting the value of omega C and later you will get a value of IC as 2 pi FC VP. What is this VP? VP over here is a phase voltage. VP over here is a phase voltage. Again, for long distance power transmission, the charging current is very high and it results in over voltages. Therefore, it's usually not recommended to transfer power for a long distance using UG cables. It's not recommended to transfer power for a long distance. Why are we not preferring UG cables for long distance power transmission? Right? Which later results in use UG cables for long. What is dielectric loss? Okay, so this is equivalent circuit of a cable is considered in order to find out the expression for dielectric loss. So cable can be considered as a type of capacitor with core and sheath forming two plates separated by a dielectric material as shown in the figure. The equivalent circuit of this is represented as shown in the figure because the equivalent circuit, we have taken a resistor RL and the capacitance C is also in parallel. What is this RL here? RL is nothing but the leakage resistance. So what dielectric loss is due to the equivalent leakage resistance loss. You will get a loss only when there is a drop. Okay, it is usually due to the equivalent leakage resistance loss. So this figure gives you the equivalent circuit and also the phasor diagram. So what is the power lost over here in the resistance? What is the expression for power lost in the resistance? So you know that P is equal to V square by R. Over here it is RL. From the phasor diagram, you can clearly write as tan theta is nothing but V divided by RL divided by V omega C. On further simplification, you will get it as V divided by RL is equal to V omega C into tan theta. So the dielectric loss the expression for dielectric loss over here is P is equal to V square omega C into tan theta. What is this theta? Theta over here is nothing but the dielectric loss angle, and omega is nothing but the supply frequency. Theta is nothing but the dielectric loss angle, and omega is nothing but the supply frequency. So as the value of theta is small, you can equate tan theta is approximately equal to theta. So later you will get the expression for power as P is equal to V square omega C into theta. Unit is watts. And from the next phasor diagram, you will also get a value for power factor angle, the dielectric. Alpha is equal to 90 degree minus theta. So later, cos alpha is equal to cos of 90 degree minus theta, which is nothing but sine theta. So let's move on to the next problem. So let's solve some of the problem over here. So to start with, we will be finding the insulation resistance of a single core cable of length 6 km with radius of conductor 10 mm and the insulation thickness 8 mm and the specific resistance of insulation is 5 into 10 power 12 ohmmeter. Okay, so for this particular problem, you are supposed to find the insulation resistance of a single core cable which is of length 6 km with a radius of 10 mm and the insulation thickness is 8 mm. So you are supposed to find out the insulation resistance, wherein they have given you the value of insulation thickness, radius of the conductor and the specific resistance of the insulation. That is nothing but 5 into 10 power 12 ohmmeters. The specific resistance of insulation is, let us write down the given value, specific resistance. Length of the cable is nothing but 6000 meters. Core radius is nothing but 10 mm. Intersheath radius is R2. Intersheath radius R2 is nothing but 18 mm. So on further simplification, you will get a value of LAN R2 by R1 as 0.5877. So the insulation resistance, the expression for insulation resistance is Ri is equal to rho by 2 pi L LAN R2 by R1. On further simplification, the value of insulation resistance is 77.94 mega ohms. Okay, so let's see. So this is the before ending today's session, let us discuss about summarize the concept that is discussed. Initially, we started with grading of cables. We also discussed why grading of cables is important and how were the advantages of capacitance grading, disadvantages of capacitance grading. We also discussed why is intersheath grading better when compared to capacitance grading, along with the disadvantages of intersheath grading and one problem on insulation resistance. Let us consider the problem. Let us solve some of the problems in the next class. Thank you.